come join us here at the CabaRay.
That's the Ray Stevens CabaRay and Showroom right here in West Nashville. We're easy to find at the Charlotte Avenue exit off I-40 West. It's the place in Nashville for a special entertainment and dining experience. There's great food, all your favorite wines and mixed drinks, a fun piano bar where you can sing along and dance. And there's the Ray Stevens Show, where I'll sing all my biggest hits with Nashville's best musicians and singers. So whether it's a special date night, entertaining friends and family, or you're just coming out to sing along in the piano bar, whatever your reason, the CabaRay is a fun place to enjoy a full night of entertainment. And the parking is free. So come see me, Ray Stevens, at the CabaRay. Call 615-327-4630 or go to raystevenscabaret.com. Make your plans now.
From the Ray Stevens Studios in the heart of Music Row in Music City, USA, it's Ray Stevens
CabaRay Nashville.
My heart keeps going back to Nashville. That's the only place for me. My love is waiting there in Nashville. Nashville, Tennessee.
With Ray's guests, Darryl Worley, Lee Greenwood, and the A-Team. And now, don't look at them. Here we go again. It's Ray Stevens.
Reporters on TV show protesters in the street. Someone burns a flag to show just how they feel. I just can't believe my eyes. They spit on the stars and stripes. How could anyone feel that way for real? And if no one's taken time to tell you lately, here's a message that you should be hearing daily. You, Army troops in tan and green, Navy, Air Force, and Marines. Thank you for doing what you do for the red, white, and blue. Thank you every time you take up arms just to keep us safe from harm. And to keep this country free. Thank you. War is not the answer, reads a big sign in the yard of some takers of this free life that we're living. We all have a choice, the right to raise our voice. But what about those brave hearts out there giving? And if no one's taken time to tell you lately, here's a message that you should be hearing daily. Thank you, Green Berets and Navy SEALs, and all you soldiers in the field. Thank you, full-time and reserve. You don't get what you deserve. Thank you, every time you take up arms, just to keep us safe from harm, or to help somebody get free. Thank you. That's a song with a positive message. And we've got an uplifting show for you. So if you love this great country and believe that our best days are still ahead of us, you're going to have a good time. There was a lot of patriotic fervor immediately after 9/11/2001. Even the Republicans and Democrats in Congress had their pictures taken together. But things died down and things began to normalize. But not for our service people in the Middle East and not for the families of the folks in the towers. And then Darryl Worley wrote and sang a song to honor them. Remember? Ladies and gentlemen, Darryl Worley, Have You Forgotten?
Hear people say we don't need this war. I say there's some things worth fighting for. What about our freedom and this piece of ground? Didn't get to keep them by backing down. They say we don't realize the mess we're getting in. Before you start your preaching, let me ask you this, my friend. Have you forgot how it felt that day to see your homeland undefiled and her people blown away? Have you forgot when those towers fell? We had neighbors still inside. Going through living hell, and you say we shouldn't worry about Bin Laden. Have you forgotten? They took all the footage off my TV, said it's too disturbing for you and me. It'll just breed anger. That's what the experts say. If it was up to me, I'd show it every day. Some say this country's just out looking for a fight. After 9/11, man, I'd have to say that's right. Have you forgot how it felt that day to see your homeland undefiled and her people blown away? Have you forgot when those towers fell? We had neighbors still inside, going through the living hell. And we vowed to get the ones behind Bin Laden. Have you forgot? There with the soldier who's gone away to war. You can bet that they remember just what they're fighting for. Have you forgotten all the people killed? Yeah, some went down like heroes in that Pennsylvania field. Have you forgotten about our Pentagon? All the loved ones that we lost and those left to carry on. Now we don't have to worry about Bin Laden. Have you forgotten? Have you forgotten? Have you forgotten?
Darryl Worley. Wonderful. Oh, wow. What a great song. What a great song.
Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Thank y'all.
Born in Memphis, raised in Pyburn, Tennessee.
That's
That's correct.
Yeah, great acts from Memphis like Elvis and Orbison and Cash, and now Worley, ladies and gentlemen.
Good company there.
That's right, it sure is. And I've worked with every one of them, and now with you. So he was signed by James Stroud?
That's correct.
Yeah, to DreamWorks.
That's right.
And that's a pretty prestigious label. When did Have You Forgotten come out?
That would have been in 2003. Yeah, we went over to the Middle East in 2002 for the first time to entertain the troops. And we've been back over there 14 or 15 times now to the war zones. But that was the inspiration for the song, that trip. I came home and I said, I just got to do something for these men and women because they do everything for us. And a lot of military in my family, so that had a... played a big part in it, too.
Yeah, well, you know, and that the Twin Towers being such an isolated incident, I mean, it was a big surprise. It wasn't anything before it. It wasn't anything right after it. And people have a tendency to just go on about their lives and forget important things like that. And I'm glad you put that out and reminded us all, because it's still viable today.
Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, a big hand for Darryl Worley. Take this opportunity to thank Mark Woods and Operation Trooping. Mark Woods, ladies and gentlemen. These fine men and women of our armed forces have joined us in the audience today, and I want to thank them for their service to our country. Our next guest has the distinction of having written the definitive American patriotic song of the last century. And nobody does it like him. Ladies and gentlemen, Lee Greenwood.
Thank you so much. Hi, everybody. If tomorrow all the things were gone, work for all my life, and I had to start again with just my children and my wife. I thank my lucky stars to be living here today, 'cause the flag still stands for freedom and they can't take that away. And I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me. And I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today, 'cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. From the lakes of Minnesota to the hills of Tennessee, across the plains of Texas, from sea to shining sea, from Detroit down to Houston and New York to LA, where there's pride in every American heart, and it's time we stand and say, I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me. And I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today, 'cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. Forget the men who died, who gave that right to me. 'cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the U.S.A.
What a song. What a song. Wow, man. You nailed it.
Thank you so very much.
How'd you happen to write that?
I was in the back of my bus one day between Texas and Arkansas, and we were touring 300 days a year, every doghouse, outhouse, roundhouse in the country, trying
about
to find
the cat houses.
And we're trying to find our country fans, and we were required to do two albums a year. It was Reba and me and George Strait and the Oak Ridge Boys, and Barbara Mandrell, and it was tour, get in, record, tour, record, and I had to write. So I was writing a lot of songs, and this just happened to be one of those that I really had a passion about, and I turned it over to my producer, Jerry Crutchfield, at the time, and I said, I really want to do this, and he said, well, it's a little out of context, but let's ask Universal what they think, and they chose it as the single. I didn't think it was going to be a single, and so therefore, America finally heard it for the first time.
Every now and then, the record companies do something right.
Every once in a while. Yeah.
Well, you nailed it. Wow.
Huge.
Lee Greenwood. Hi, this is Ray Stevens with some great news. My CabaRay gift shop has gone digital. You no longer have to drive to Tennessee to see all the stuff we have for you to enjoy and buy. Take your time and take a nice long look around at all the ball caps, t-shirts, monkeys and squirrels. We have keychains, cups, mouse pads, and books, CDs, DVDs, and so much more. Everything we have in the gift shop is now available to you here online. So fill up that shopping cart.
And now, Ray sings A Letter to America.
Dear America, I promise you, I teach my children of your freedom and your grace, of the founding fathers' wisdom in the writings that they made. Dear America, I won't let them forget the sacrifice that your men and women made, and that our flag still flies from the dying breath they gave. Dear America, no, I won't back down from our enemies, and I'll gain my strength by praying on my knees, and I'll trust in the one who has always kept us free. This I promise you, all my days are through. Dear America,
dear America,
dear America, I give my word that I will not forget that dark September day, when we learned that others hate us and it took our breath away. Dear America, no, I won't forget the families who hold a photograph and a thousand vivid memories and a neatly folded flag. Dear America, I won't back down from our enemies, and I'll gain my strength by praying on my knees, and I'll trust in the one who has always kept us free. This I promise you, till all my days are through, dear America. I pledge my sacred honor, I pledge my fortune too, and if they come back the next time, they'll have to go through me to get to you. This I promise you. Thanks for being with us, and thanks to Darryl Worley and Lee Greenwood for their songs that help us express our patriotism. And once again, a special thank you to Mark Woods and Operation Troop Aid for all they do to help our servicemen and women. See you next time, and God bless the USA. She needs it. Ma'am, would you dance with me? Oh, thank you.
Recorded before a live audience in the Ray Stevens Studios in Nashville, Tennessee, Music City, USA. This is Bill Cody. We'll see you next time.
Come join us here at the CabaRay. That's the Ray Stevens CabaRay and Showroom right here in West Nashville. We're easy to find at the Charlotte Avenue exit off I-40 West. It's the place in Nashville for a special entertainment and dining experience. There's great food, all your favorite wines and mixed drinks, a fun piano bar where you can sing along and dance. And there's the Ray Stevens Show, where I'll sing all my biggest hits with Nashville's best musicians and singers. So whether it's a special date night, entertaining friends and family, or you're just coming out to sing along in the piano bar, whatever your reason, the CabaRay is a fun place to enjoy a full night of entertainment. And the parking is free. So come see me, Ray Stevens, at the CabaRay. Call 615-327-4630 or go to raystevenscabaret.com. Make your plans now.